High Court Judge Isaac Mwata yesterday continued in a trial of Molly Katanga and her co-accused George Amanyile, a domestic worker, and Charles Otai, a nursing officer, and her two daughters, Patricia Kakwanza and Martha Nkwanzi, also accused of destroying evidence in the murder case of businessman Henry Katanga.
The defense will be at liberty to cross-examine on the same reports to test the veracity of the information stated by the prosecutor in the summary of the case, when those who looked at the impugned reports are going to testify. I shall find.
Judge Mwata approached the resumption of the trial today with a potentially damaging recusal decision, where taking Wakoli out of the case would have confirmed prosecutorial bias and left the charges against Katanga on its deathbed even before the first witness had been summoned to the dock. The defense team led by Jet Tumwebaze did not challenge the decision. Judge Mwata allowed Molly to attend the trial remotely from Luzira Prison via video link. The prosecution bench notified the court that they were ready to present three witnesses in this case, and they immediately commenced with the testimony of Mwanguzi Julius, who examined the accused persons.
Yeah, they were seated for sure. You find them some space to sit.
Out of life, my lord.
Yeah.
I'm not able to confirm right now, my lord.
But you have the stamp.
Yes, I can bring the stampers. I can bring.
Mwanguzi was also cross-examined by both the prosecution and defense bench. Henry Katanga succumbed to a gunshot wound he sustained on his head on November 2, 2023 at their residence at Mbuyachwa 2 Road in Kampala. The government has devised a plan to reduce traffic jam in the Kampala metropolitan area. This includes Mukono District, Kira Municipality, Entebbe and Mpiji. This initiative was launched by the State Minister for Kampala, Kabuye Chofatogabye, at Mukono Municipal Headquarters. Chofatogabye said that after examining the challenges in Kampala metropolitan area, traffic jam is a major challenge. This is the reason why most of the roads in these areas are being tarmacked. After identifying that the major problem in Kampala and the metropolitan area is bad roads and poor drainage, we decided to make it a priority. What remains is the work for expatriates. The roads to be considered in the first phase are Nasuti Nakabago to Ntawo Bajo, and the contract has been awarded to Sterling Engineering Limited.
And I promise you that I will do not my best, more than my best, to make all of you happy.
Minister Chofatogabye said 43.7 billion is what has been allocated for the construction of this 9.7 kilometer road. Mukono Town Clerk Francis Byabagambi, Municipal Engineer Charles Mokasa Dongo, and the contractor signed the contracts to this effect. Crews yesterday battled wildfires raging in southern Albania as a heatwave sweeps the Balkans, said authorities who charged a suspect in connection with the flames. Firefighters, backed by helicopter, brought several blazes under control, but high temperatures and winds have spurred the flames near the villages of Dropul and Finik. The suspect is accused of arson, the 18th person to face an arson charge over the last month for sparking wildfires across Albania, police said. A heatwave expected to last until the end of the week has swept across the Balkans, with temperatures surpassing 40 degrees Celsius in Albania.